All right, I said if Todd got Aaron Rodgers on the phone and in the final segment, then I would take a pie to the face. So I took a pie to the face right at the end of the show, and then right as we went to commercial, I took what the remnants of the pie.
Then you hit me in the with a pie like in my right ear, which is like still a little swollen.
And Todd's going, you know, I was coming into New York and I was clicking by my ear to hear if I could hear it correctly. Can you hear me now?
If I put the volume up really loud, if I dial this up to like 11 or 12 on the thing
okay.
in the box.
All right. I want you to be able to hear this. You are soft. Here was a discussion point that we had today. Is chili a soup? Hot dog's not a sandwich. Is chili a soup?
Sometimes when you go into restaurants and they'll say soup of the day, and I've seen chili on there. I don't think chili is a soup. I think chili is chili. But it is a bunch of stuff in a pot cooked up with a broth.
Both soup and stew are a combination of vegetables, meat, or fish cooked in liquid. What sets these two warm and hearty dishes apart is the amount of liquid that's used for each, with stews generally containing less liquid.
Oh my God!
Right there.
I think no, there's like something feels funny over here, though. There's like a little scratch here.
Oh, it's so sore.
It was seriously reddish purple, though. And like I was like going like this, it sounded louder in this ear, and then like this, it sounded like.
Oh!
There's like a faint snapping.
How was that, Todd? Could you hear that?
That hurt my ear a little.
Somebody just threw out another thing here.
What?
Is cereal a soup? Okay, right. On its surface, you're like, that's just dumb. But why? What's the difference?
My head's gonna explode.
Which means that oatmeal is probably the chili of cereals.
Yes, I would buy that. Yes. If hot dog is the chili of sandwiches, oatmeal is the chili of cereals.
Right, but which cereal should be considered a soup?
By the way, I'm drinking warm watermelon juice.
Why?
I thought for some reason that it was recommended to me by a doctor, and then McLovin goes, you had a member of the audience, a listener, suggested you drink watermelon.
Some guy named Steve told you.
Yes, and that, because I have kidney stones, that this is good for you. And then Seton goes, do you know watermelon juice or water is an aphrodisiac, or it's like Viagra?
It's supposed to be like sort of like nature's Viagra.
I hope Michael Phelps doesn't think I'm that excited to see him.
Very excited to see
him.
Hi,
Mike.
Stay behind the desk, pal. You'll be okay.
I'm not going to get up, Mike. Michael Phelps joining us. You don't wear Speedos.
Yes, we don't say that word.
Don't say Speedos. When did we get rid of Speedos?
I haven't been with them for a while.
Yeah. But you have your own brand.
Correct.
Yes.
MP.
Yeah. Yes.
Because that's kind of like Q-tip, right? It's really called like a cotton swab, but it's like a brand.
Right.
Right?
Right.
Okay.
There are other names for it, but it's some of them probably inappropriate for television.
Well, you could try it.
No, I don't
you
think
got one?
So. I'm going to. You guys can do some research online. I'm sure you can figure out a couple good ones.
Like nut smugglers? Or?
Yeah, that's a good one.
All right. Yep.
Tune in to The Dan Patrick Show, weekday mornings on Audience, or the DP Show app.